done this bike in a previous segment on this YouTube on my channel. It's a Trident frame widened in the rear, and the engine is a Norton crank with a big bore, so it's stroked out. It's 828, 810 or 828, as I can't really remember. I got like a Harley knockoff front end on it, and some Nissan calipers up front, which are pretty good on the old Harley disc, but it's a Triumph front wheel laced up. Anyway, it's not a bad little thing. It gets along well. I just wanted to take it for a ride and show you that, you know, as a knockoff 70 model to look alike, with the 850, it's geared at 2142. That's 2-to-1. So the speedo is good because it's a Harley 2-to-1 drive and a Triumph 2-to-1 speedo. And it actually, at 3,000 RPM, you're doing 60 mile an hour. And now, on the original 650s from the factory, they had a 19.2 sprocket on a 46 rear, and they were doing 4,000 at 60 mile an hour. Anyway, let's just see if it's going to fire up for me. I'll give it a kick without choking. It might need one with. Choke. These are a pair of 34 Mark IIs, which are, you know, biggie sort of carbs, but they work well with this engine being basically an 850 or right up there. Oops, cut the clutches a bit from 30. You can tell why it pulled off the line there. The gearing is fairly tall, but the capacity of the engine, it's got plenty of pull to do this. Pull the tall gearing. Carburetors, they work quite good. I've just been fiddling about with that Norton Commando Triton before, and I've had to flip the PWKs. I just got sick of them, went back to a pair of Warnhole body 32mm Amel concentrics with a new pair of slides, and what do you know, away it went. Not that the PWKs aren't any good, it's just that I could not get them to work on that particular bike. When in doubt, shove an Amel on it. But I do like the Mark IIs. Quite a modern sort of carburetor. Now this only has a 4-speed gearbox. That's all it needs. It's got plenty of torque. Just a cruiser. 50 mile an hour. Okay, we're running on modern highway. Putting the Norton crank in it and running that slightly, that big bore, it, you know, puts it up in the same engine capacity, but as an 850 Norton, and also gives it that torque and the cruisability of an 850 Norton. The bobber and the chopper that I rode have the same engine size configuration. Both have only got 4 speed, but they're running a little bit harder. The tooth, I've got 3 tooth different on the back, so they're a bit quicker off the mark, but they rev a little bit more. Not much. Just a quick ride so that you can have a look at the cruisability or capability of a stroked out big bore Trident. Thanks for watching.